हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 1 एंड 2 ऑफ क्लास 8 सब्जेक्ट सोशल स्टडीज़ हिस्ट्री चैप्टर 1 एंड 2. चैप्टर नंबर 1 हाउ व्हेन एंड वेयर एंड चैप्टर नंबर 2 फ्रॉम ट्रेड टू टेरिटरी. सो हियर वी आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट द प्रैक्टिस टाइम. फर्स्ट वी विल डू द टिक द करेक्ट आंसर, देन फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स ट्रू एंड फॉल्स, एंड आफ्टर दैट मैच द फॉलोइंग एंड द आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चंस. Okay, now first one, Indian historians divided Indian history into dash parts. So the answer is 3. So here you have to write, take the C part. Okay, next, dash is a process by which a central system of power dominates the surrounding land and its components. So the answer is colonization. Third one, the British felt all important dash needed to be preserved. So the answer is letter and document, C1. Next, fill in the blanks. The first full-scale working railway steam locomotive was built in the United Kingdom in the year. The answer is 1804. Next, history is certainly about dash that occurred over time. So the answer is events. Third, census operations were held every dash years. 10. British established specialized institutions like dash and dash to preserve important records. The answer is museums, archives. MUSEUMSARCHIVES. The Imperial Record Department was set up on 11th March 1891 in dash Calcutta, Kolkata. Calcutta bracket Kolkata. State whether the statements are true or false. Dates in history are not linked to events. It is false. James Mill divided Indian history into 3 periods, Hindu, Muslim, Christian. It is also false. The practice of surveying also became common under the colonial administration. It is true. Official documents help us understand about the country administration. True. The British thought surveys were important for effective administration. True. Now, write answers in short. Richard Trevithick. The answer is invention of train. James Mill. Periodization of Indian history. Ravlott Act. Jallianwala Bagh Massacre. Simon Commission. Political reform in India. Pune Pact. M.K. Gandhi, P.R. Ambedkar. Now answer in short. The answers I will show you and you are going to write in your notebooks. I will speak the answers for you. Okay children, now. So the first one, what do you mean by history? So children, the answer is, history is study of past and a record of past events. Okay, next, second question, who was James Mill? James Mill was a Scottish philosopher, historian and economist. Third one question, what did James Mill think about all Asian societies? James Mill has a colonial mindset and he thought all the ancients to be poorly civilized. Fourth one, how have historians divided Indian history? Historians have divided Indian history into ancient, medieval and modern period. What do you mean by the term colonization? Colonization is a process by which a central system of power dominates the surrounding land and its components. Mention the events for which specific dates can be determined. Specific dates can be determined for the time when a king ruled a particular kingdom, the time when he became a king or fought a war, or when a particular invention took place. Next, write answers to the long questions. First one, why are dates important? Dates serve to mark periods in history and act as milestones. They tell us about the events, incidents, and different developments which took place. Dates tell us when a king ascended his throne, the time period for which he ruled, and the time when he was involved in war. They also act as a landmark due to their long term period. Though dates, we compare the past with the present, we come to know about the inventions and development which take place in the human society. We study dates to find out the sequence of the dates and their significance. Dates also help to establish relationship between various events. Though dates we come to know during the struggle for independence have events took place one after the other. Second, what periodization was done by James Mill? What were Indian historians against this? James Mill divided Indian history into Hindu, Muslim, and British period. This periodization is based on the religious line that there were a phase when a particular community ruled upon the communities. Firstly, there were the rules of the Hindus, followed by the Muslims and the British. However, various historians found James Mill's divided on the basis of the religion incorrect, because in the fact, though such division, James Mill tried to divide people with their own specified identity, which was not right. What do you understand by periodization in history? Periodization is the process of study of categorizing the past into discrete quantified named blocks of time. This is usually done in order to facilitate the history and analyze of history, understanding current and historical processes and casualties that might have linked to those events. To the extent that history is continuous and all the system of periodizations are arbitrary, there are significant sources of history study the periods of events, and by studying different historical evidences, a string of time periods can be formed. Why did British conduct surveys in India? The British conduct surveys for the purpose of effective administration. These surveys helped the historians to collect information about modern history India. Botanical, zoological, archaeological, and anthropological surveys were there in the list of British administration. Why were records maintained? How were they maintained? Maintenance of records were needed for proper study and debate on various issues, so the British carefully preserved all the official records and created several museums and archives for this purpose. There were different levels of care for the records, and a keeper of East India Company records appointed in 1771 with the mission of arranging current records and preserving historical records. Towards the end of the East India Company's governance in India, many documents were sent to the London and were incorporated with records. Now we are going to do chapter number 2, that is the from trade to territory. Okay, so children, open the page number where is the practice time given in your textbook. It is on page number 26. Okay, so open page number 26. Now, first one we have, take the correct answers. Okay, so we are going to complete first the take the correct answers. Then we have fill in the blanks, and after that we have match these columns. Then we are having true and false. So the first one. In dash, Queen Elizabeth gave a character to the English East India Company. So the answer is 1600 A1. The Governor General introduced a system of subsidiary alliance. So the answer is Lord Wellesley, C1. Who expanded British influence through the doctrine of lapse? Answer is Lord Dalhousie, D1. Fourth one, the company drafted dash to govern the conquered territories. So the answer is annexation policy. Fill in the blank. First, the British conquest of Bengal began with the Battle of प्लासी, PLASSEY, प्लासी। हैदर अली एंड टीपू सुल्तान वर द रूलर्स ऑफ मैसूर। डलहौजी इम्प्लीमेंटेड द डॉक्ट्राइन ऑफ लैप्स। मराठा किंगडम्स वर लोकेटेड मेनली इन द डैश पार्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया। साउथ वेस्टर्न। द फर्स्ट एंग्लो मराठा वॉर एंडेड विद द ट्रीटी ऑफ मद्रास। इन अ सब्सिडरी लाइन्स प्रिंसली रूलर्स वर नॉट अलाउड टू मेक एनी डैश एंड डैश विद एनी अदर रूलर्स। अलाइंस डिक्लेयर वॉर। मैच द कॉलम्स। क्वीन एलिजाबेथ, रॉयल कैरेक्टर ऑफ EIC। सर थॉमस रॉ, जहांगीर, औरंगजेब, ड्यूटी फ्री ट्रेड ऑफ IEC, रॉबर्ट क्लिव, बैटल ऑफ प्लासी, हेक्टर मुरानो, बैटल ऑफ बक्सर। ट्रू एंड फॉल्स। द मुगल एम्परर बिकेम स्ट्रॉन्गर इन द 18th century। इट इज फॉल्स। द इंग्लिश ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी वॉज द ओनली यूरोपियन कंपनी दैट ट्रेडेड विद इंडिया। इट इज अगेन फॉल्स। द ब्रिटिश डिड नॉट इंट्रोड्यूस एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव चेंजेस इन द टेरिटरीज दे कॉन्कर। फॉल्स। द रॉयल कैरेक्टर कुड नॉट प्रिवेंट अदर यूरोपियन पावर्स फ्रॉम एंटरिंग द ईस्टर्न मार्केट। फॉल्स। द थर्ड एंग्लो मराठा वॉर ऑफ 1817 and 1819 क्रश्ड मराठा पावर। ट्रू। टीपू सुल्तान डिसअलाउड लोकल मर्चेंट्स फ्रॉम ट्रेडिंग विद द कंपनी। ट्रू। नाउ आंसर द फॉलोइंग इन 1 to 2 लाइन्स एंड आंसर द फॉलोइंग इन 4 to 5 लाइन्स। द आंसर्स आई विल बी गिविंग यू, सो यू आर गोइंग टू राइट द आंसर्स इन योर नोटबुक एंड द बुक वर्क यू आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट इन योर textbook only. So the first one is, how and when did the British East India Company set foot in India? The answer is, in 1612 James I instructed Sir Thomas Roe to visit the Mughal Emperor Jahangir to arrange for a commercial treaty that would prove exclusive rights to the East India Company to reside and established factories in Surat and other areas. This mission was highly successful and thus the company set its foot in India. Second one, which were the other trading companies that come to the Indian shores? Portugal, Dutch and French companies were other trading companies that come to the Indian shore. Between whose armies was the Battle of Plassey fought? The Battle of Plassey was fought between the British East India Company and the Nawab of Bengal and his French allies. What was the doctrine of Lapps? The doctrine of Lapps was an annexation policy purported devised by Lord Dalhousie, who was the Governor General for the East India Company in India between 1848 and 1856. The latter supplanted the long established right of an Indian sovereign without an heir to choose a successor. Why did the British need a large army? The British needed a large army in order to keep themselves secure, to fight against their enemies and conquer various parts of India. Next, answer these questions in 4 to 5 lines each. First one, give a brief note on the Battle of Plassey. The Battle of Plassey was a decisive victory of the British East India Company over the Nawab of Bengal and his French alliance on 23rd June 1757 under the leadership of Lord Sylhet. The battle helped the British occupy Bengal. The battle took place at Plassey on the banks of the Hooghly River. Sutcliffe defeated Sirajuddin in the battle and captured Calcutta, victory of the British in this battle resulted in various puppet government instated in various states of India by the British. This led to an unleashed successive malpractice and atrocities by the British East India Company in the name of tax collection. Second, who was Tipu Sultan? Why did he fight with the British? Tipu Sultan was the ruler of Kingdom of Mysore and the pioneer of rocket artillery. Mysore controlled the profitable trade of the Malabar coast, where the company purchased pepper and cardamom. In 1785, Tipu Sultan stopped the export of sandalwood, pepper and cardamom through the ports of his kingdom and disallowed local merchants from trading with the company. He also established a close relationship with the French in India and modernized his army with their help. Tipu Sultan was one of the biggest threat and this was the main reason the British started conflict against the Mysore state. Third, explain the system of subsidiary alliance. Under the system of subsidiary alliance, princely rulers were not allowed to make any negotiation and treaty with any other rulers. They were also not allowed to have an independent armed forces. They were to be protected by the East India Company, but they had to pay for the subsidiary forces that the company provided for their protection. If Indian rulers failed to make payments, part of their treaty was taken away as penalty. For example, the Nawab of Awadh was forced to give away more than half of his treaty to the company in 1801 in pretense of maladministration. Hyderabad was also forced to give away its part on similar grounds. Fourth, give a brief account of Anglo-Maratha War. From the late 18th century, the company also made efforts to curb and eventually destroy Maratha power. With their defeat in the Third Battle of Panipat in 1761, the Maratha dream of ruling from Delhi was shattered. They were divided into various states under different chiefs, Sardars, belonging to dynasties like Sindhia, Holkar, Gaikwad and Bhonsle. These chiefs were held together in a confederacy under a Peshwa principal minister who became its effective military and administrative head based in Pune. Mahadji Sindhya and Nana Padnias were two popular Maratha soldiers and statesmen of the late 18th century. The Marathas were subdued in a series of wars. In the first war that ended in 1782 with the Treaty of Salbai, there was no clear victory. The Second Anglo-Maratha War, 1803 and 5, was fought on various fronts, resulting in the British gaining Orissa and the territories north of the Yamuna River, including Agra and Delhi. Finally, the Third Anglo-Maratha War of 1817 and 19 cursed Maratha power. The Peshwa was removed and exiled to Bithur near Kanpur with a pension. The company now had complete control over the territories south of the Vindhyas. Give a brief account of the Battle of Buxar. The Battle of Buxar was fought in 1764 between the English East India Company on one hand and alliance of Mir Kazim, Shujaudullah and Mughal Emperor Shah Alam. The battle took place following a chain of events. Firstly, Mir Jafar, the new Nawab of Bengal, was unable to meet the demands of the British. As a result, in 1760, the company deposed Mir Jafar and made his son-in-law Mir Kazim the Nawab of Bengal. Mir Kazim also wanted to end the company's domination and assert his authority. Thus, he denied the British undue trade privileges. So, the company declared war against Mir Kazim and defeated him in 1763. Mir Jafar was again made the Nawab of Bengal. So, you are going to complete chapter number 1 and chapter number 2 of history in your notebooks. The book exercise you are going to complete in the textbook only. The question and answers in the copy. Okay. So complete your work on page number 7 and 8 and the question answers in your notebook. and page number 26 and 27 and the question answers in your notebook. So complete your work and learn for your exams. Thank you.